inherent beauty and tranquility. It is just be for the success of this mission, but for an enduring peace among the people of all nations. Our Lord, 1984, I ask for the prayers of all Americans and the people of the world for peace among men and peace among nations. These islands cherish peace. Unlike most of their countrymen, the people of Hawaii have known firsthand the destruction wrought by nations that take up arms. We reflected on the Arizona Memorial beneath us. The building that is now the Pacific Air Force's headquarters is still pockmarked with bullets from prisoners of war returned from an awful captivity in North Vietnam. The American people have never sought war. Hawaii remains key to this resolve and readiness. To our men and women in uniform today, I bring the greetings and gratitude of your country. In these islands, we'll renounce forever the use of force. It's our fervent hope that the events of this coming week will also bring us closer to that day. One of the critically important geopolitical situations, such as our disapproval of the aggression waged against the peoples of Cambodia and Afghanistan. Our shared progress did not happen instantly. It took more than a decade. One of the fastest growing markets for American goods, services, and investments. Our nature's future is in the Pacific. This is why we're especially glad to begin our journey here in Hawaii, the crossroads of the Pacific, your 50th and younger state.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's nice because it's
we're grateful to you and your hospitality for this chance to rest and relax, to enjoy Hawaii's beauty and the warmth of her people. So,
Yeah.